Hello, I'm Greg Nichols, the Science and Technology Advisor for the Homeland Defense and Security Information Analysis Center. Today we're going to talk about facial recognition technologies, or more specifically, anti-facial recognition technologies. So facial recognition is a technology which uses a software usually connected to a camera of some kind or some sort of video feed where the software can recognize different shapes of a person's face. And taking that information, it can basically work with other databases that already have a person's face, and it can find a match and identify that person. And current facial recognition technologies have about a 98% accuracy. What some people are actually working on are what we call anti-facial recognition technologies, or things that have the ability to counter these methods of detecting and identifying a person's face. One of the most commonly used technologies are reflective glasses. What they actually do is they don't allow shadows to be cast on the face, so it's very difficult for the software to pick up on different types of contours to identify a person's face. Some of the other technologies being developed are visors that have like a mesh that also interferes with the contours and the lines of the face. So it makes it really difficult to determine who it actually is. Some clothing manufacturers are actually getting in on the market as well. And so some designers have figured out that you can actually overwhelm the video feeds of these surveillance cameras if you actually create like a dress or something that has faces on it itself. The video can't recognize and distinguish all of the faces at one time, so basically it becomes overwhelmed and shuts down. And there are some other designers who are looking at using metallic threads. The metallic clothing actually creates interference with the video feed, and so it makes it very difficult to determine the exact lines and features on a face. So despite all of this, facial recognition technologies are actually still used quite often, will probably increase as well. They have a lot of good applications. They're accurate, they're relatively easy to implement, and you can screen a whole bunch of people in a short period of time. They're commonly used at airports, border crossings, things like that. So thanks for tuning in today. Just want to remind you that you can find more information about biometrics and about anti-facial recognition technologies on our website, hdiac.org. And don't forget to follow us on Twitter.